Post-traumatic stress disorder is a serious illness affecting millions of military servicemen and women. Now a new film, That Which I Love Destroys Me, takes us on a very personal journey through the eyes of two servicemen, Jason Floyd and Tyler Gray. Today they are here to join us. Good morning to you both.
Good morning, Robin.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you for being here. This was an incredible film, really difficult to watch, and it really makes many of us realize what you have gone through. So first of all, thank you for your service.
Absolutely, and I mean, again, it's not, the film is obviously told, you know, from the personal story of me and Jason, but it's not necessarily, it's our story that we put on film, but it's really, we had to put ourselves out there to hopefully invite others to talk about themselves. And by no means are we even remotely the worst case situation, or I mean, there's far, far, far people with greater issues or have been through 1,000 times more things. It's just, we had to put ourselves out there to hopefully invite people, veterans and families of veterans, to talk about themselves.
Well, it does exactly that, particularly because you both were so candid. Not only did you have the director follow you for 3 years, but Tyler, I saw in the film that you had your personal diary, your video diary, up for since 2005. For both of you, Jason as well, how difficult was it to expose yourself in that way for such a long time?
Well, we knew if we were going to do it, we had, you know, to do it right, we had to be completely honest. And that takes a lot of trust, especially for us. We really didn't want to talk about it in the beginning, but we knew that we had a certain responsibility to the viewer that's going to be watching it. So the only rule that we had from the very beginning was just blazing honesty and to rip the scab off and show the wound. And that's the only way we were going to get people to relate.
Mm-hmm. And Tyler, did you ever have any hesitation about showing your video diary? That seemed incredibly personal as well.
So quick funny story on that. I actually didn't, we filmed or were in the process of filming for a year and a half before I told Rick about the diaries. And he kind of looked at me and went, okay, so are you gonna give them to us? Well, you know, he was kind of weirded out. And, you know, there really wasn't any hesitation, only because exactly what Jason just said, which is, you know, you can't, if you're going to really try and help people and you're really going to try and talk about a subject that no one wants to talk about, you got to go all out, and you got to completely put yourself out there. And so, no, there wasn't any hesitation. That being said, you know, I can't watch it, just because it's a very personal, you know, a very personal piece of a personal time. It's meant for other people at this point. It's not meant for myself.
That's interesting that you mentioned that, because I wanted to know if you were able to watch the film and what you thought about it, because there are some really poignant moments, not to give too much away of the film, but I mean, Tyler, when you were going up that rope in the American Forces Challenge, I mean, that was incredible. And also, Jason, you had some pretty personal moments with your brother. I mean, were you able to go back and watch that, or just being there, was that enough?
Well, the first time that Tyler and I watched it was very therapeutic for both of us. But we're currently in the process of a 10-city tour right now across the United States, trying to spread the message and take it, show it to the people. And we've chosen not to watch it during the tour. It just it's one of those things now where it's not our movie anymore; it's everyone's movie, and we're past the point of looking back on. We didn't actually, during the process, see any of the footage. That was one of the key things for both of us, is we didn't want to track ourselves through the process. We wanted to be captured for the first time in real time, without editing ourselves or trying to push a message. So I think it's therapeutic when we saw it the first time.
I watched it. The first time I watched a millisecond of footage was when I watched the entire completed film in its entirety. I watched it one time, and it was therapeutic in that way. But like Jason just said, at that point, it's a tool that we are utilizing to help others. So, you know, it's not about me, it's not about Jason anymore. It's about using that to help others. So,
okay,
we don't really get anything more from it for ourselves. It's more how can we use it to help.
Okay, that being said, there have been a number of films, particularly lately, that are trying to do the same thing that you're doing in terms of spreading the message. For example, American Sniper, obviously, and just recently the Academy Award winning documentary short Veterans Press One are really exposing what it's like for servicemen and women to come back with PTSD. How do you think your film ranks along those, and do you feel comforted that there are other messages out there, other people out there trying to send the same message that you are?
We think our film's the best film. I mean, it's just
it's one of those things where
it's currently part of the zeitgeist of what we're going through right now with as a society. And when we started making this 5 years ago, it wasn't something that was topical. We didn't have the agenda. We didn't know what the response was going to be when it was finished. So the timing just seems to be perfect right now to have this documentary and be doing the tour that we're doing to promote it.
And something like, with Veterans Press One, American Sniper, I mean, the fact that, you know, and again, I'm going to use PTSD in quotations because it's such a broad term for a specific problem, at least in the military context. I mean, you could have PTSD from being a car accident, being, you know, abused as a child. It's a very broad term for within the context of what we're talking about, which is very specific. But both of those films dealing with it the way they do and addressing it, things get solved by talking about them, being open about them, processing them, not just as individuals, but as a society, and then coming to some kind of collective understanding and collective healing. And I think that all these films that are talking about this issue are helping society and veterans and their families to do that.
Okay, well, one more thing along those lines then. What can the average person do? Because I think many of us don't know what to do. We say thank you and it just doesn't seem like it's enough. And I think a lot of us want to really do more. So what can we do?
Well, the first thing is just to normalize what veterans go through when they come back. There's a stigma associated with PTSD right now. And hopefully if there was one message that we have attached to the documentary, just to tear down that stigma. So simply just by watching this documentary, anybody and everybody in whole, it normalizes that process for veterans when they come back. And that's the whole goal. That's the whole message that we have.
Yeah, which specifically for what we're doing for the month of March, a great thing that anyone can do is, you know, go to takepart.com /vets and, you know, look at the Return to Service campaign. They can view the documentary for free the entire month of March. And just find a way. There's many different avenues on the Take Part site to get involved. And you know, what Rick, the director, always says is get your hands dirty. And like you said, there's thank you and then there's action. And people want to do action or take action. They just don't know how. Go to takepart.com/vets and find out how to do that.